Hello everyone, this is Karan here. You are welcome to Tech Karan YouTube channel, and I'm back again with the new video review, the new ROM review actually, and this time it's Bootleggers OS. It is based on Android 10 version, as you can see, and this is the unofficial build of Bootleggers version, and you get the security patch of 1st of January 2020. What are the features you get in this custom ROM and how to install this ROM? Is Google camera is working or not? And everything in this video, what are the bugs in this ROM? Make sure you watch this video till the end. I will try to show you almost everything. So now let's get straight to the video. Okay, so first of all, as you can see the wallpaper, Volte they said. I didn't got the Volte icon here, but yes, Volte is properly working. Even Wo Wi-Fi is also properly working. You get something new launcher when I go to about app info. I get the Shishu food lettuce. If you have ever used Bootleggers OS before this, and then you know the about Shishu's food lettuce. This is actually Chinese ROM, I think. And it is based on AOSP Launcher 3, Shishu Launcher by Bootleggers ROM, their own launcher, and these are the special thanks by them, launcher team, Omni ROM, Dirt Unicorns, Lineage OS, Lean Launcher, etc. This is based on these launchers, and you get these type of customization options are there. You can choose the icons, okay, home screen, these are the things you get, app drawer, which is not properly working in my case. Miscellaneous and about, you cannot do any icon customizations, you cannot do other things at all. So without customization, launcher is there, and when you swipe down you get notification drawer here with the accent color of pink, and when you edit from here you get these quick tiles which you can edit, which you can place here, and when you click here you don't have the option to customize these tiles, so no better customizations are there. And what are the other things you get? The camera, as I said, Snapdragon camera, which is properly working, no issues at all. But yes, Google camera in my case is not working. When you click photos, it is force closing. I don't know why. So Google camera 7.2 in my case is not working. I will try other Google camera too, and I will comment if anyone went, if anything worked. And this is the gallery app you get. Now let's move on to other things. You don't get Google Apps pre-built, as I said always. So how to install this ROM is very simple. I already made a video before this, and you get to know about how to install these ROMs. You get the Mi Explorer by default as a file manager in this custom ROM, and which is a good thing. And also I think you get the phonograph music player with it, which you can use this on your device. Now let's move on to other things. You get in styles and wallpaper options, where you cannot change the style, you only get wallpapers options, so you cannot get the styles option even in this custom ROM. In network and internet you have these options, and when you go to SIM you have the option of Wi-Fi calling option available. Wi-Fi calling is properly working as you are using Android 10 based custom ROM. Now let's move on back to other things. Apps and notifications. And when you go to battery percentage option is there, and last full charge only 70 minutes ago. I've just installed this ROM, so I cannot show you the battery backup also. I will try to tell you how about the battery backup. Adaptive brightness option is there. Font size, notch behavior, as you can see, this is a simple feature I got. You can see there is no notch. You can change from here notch behavior to default or hidden, which is a good thing that I get the notch behavior option in a custom ROM, AOSP based custom ROM, which is a good thing. I didn't got this option in any other custom ROM except MIUI 11 modded ROMs, etc. In sound and vibration, you have the option vibrate for calls, which is properly working. And yes, touch vibration, haptic feedback for tab, keypad or keyboard or more, etc. Nothing is working. This is a bug. In privacy options, you have these options, autofill service from Google, activity server, activity controls, ads and blah blah and all. In screen lock, you have the option of fingerprint and screen lock both available. As you can see, my phone is encrypted, so you get the fingerprint option. If you are encrypted like me, you will get the fingerprint option for sure. And in other things, you have the option of languages, keyboard, gestures. As you can see, I'm using gestures, so gestures properly working, no issues at all. Now let's go back again. In developer options, you have these options which were almost same in all custom ROMs. So this was all from the settings and what you get in bootleg dumpster. I thought there would be many options, but unfortunately you don't get many options in quick settings. You only have the option of UI tweaks like show permissions chip and music title track title. Okay, and in hardware buttons you have the option of only volume keys as a music control or screen of torch. In lock screen you have the option of show media cover art, pulse, ambient display, new song, fingerprint, authentication, vibration. Only two or three options are there in notifications, in noisy notifications, etc. In animations, only screen of animation is there, miscellaneous, only full screen apps, and at last about bootleggers, so no customization, no better. There are many ROMs which have better customization than bootleggers, so if you want customization on your device, then you can try other custom ROMs. I'm just telling you, I'm just informing you about the bootleggers OS, how it feels on your device. So this was on the settings, and now let's move on straight to installation process, how to install this ROM. And you can see I don't have the advanced reboot option. When I click on restart, it is restarting, so I cannot boot directly into custom recovery, which is also not a good thing. So let me manually go to recovery. I recommend you to use official TWRP recovery or pitch black custom recovery, whatever your choice, and then just open the recovery. Wait, let me show you. You can use any other recovery like Orange Fox also, but it's your choice. I will not be responsible for anything. As you already see, my data is encrypted, so I have to fill the pattern to decrypt my data, and it is trying decryption and data successfully decrypted. What you have to do is simply just go to wipe, advanced wipe, data, Calvich data, vendor, system, cache, Dalvik, everything, swipe to wipe. Just go back and go to install. Here you have to click on bootleggers ROM Q4Gingo, simply swipe to confirm flash, and after that simply reboot as I always said. And after reboot, after first boot, just go back to recovery again, go to install and flash open gapps 10.0 pico, swipe to confirm flash, and after that again reboot. Your phone will be properly working, no bugs you will face in installing these ROM. So this was all from today's video. I hope you like it. I'm soon back with another video, so make sure you watch this video. Make sure to subscribe me and hit the bell icon to get notified for all those new videos. So now goodbye, see you in the next video.